Okay, so here we have a directory. This is a Odin project. It doesn't look like it, but yeah, this is all you need for an Odin project. And I'm gonna go over some of the key things that I think make Odin sort of that make it tick, like the very basics, right? And I think one of them is actually a much bigger deal than it might seem. Packages in Odin. A package is basically it's like a what you would say just a package in, for example, a crate in Rust, a dependency, effectively. That doesn't mean it comes from elsewhere, to be clear, right? But yeah, a package is just a directory in Odin. And that's an interesting idea. Every directory is just a package, right? So for example, I'm in this project here. The actual folder I'm in right now is called Sandbox. I generally speaking just name, I have a folder in that folder that's called the same thing, right? So if my project is something, I will just have something as a folder here, right? And the only thing we actually need to do, right now, Sandbox has nothing in it, right? It's completely empty. The only thing we actually need to do here, and I tend to do this when I have a main binary that I want to use in my project, is we have a file, so that's called project name.odin, right? This is our, we're going to produce a binary from this. And now I've written this. Here we have, we need a package declaration first. So what we're going to do is package sandbox. Now, this is now compiling, basically. We are going to say main equals proc, like this. And here we're going to use a package from the core library. So fmt print printf, actually we can do println, hello. And here we're going to need an import because we don't have any idea what this name is. So import core fmt. And now we should have a binary. So now if I say Odin build, we can also do Odin run. So here we can do Odin build sandbox. That's all we needed to actually do. Now we're gonna have sandbox.bin in our directory here. That's really it. That's all we need to build a binary. We created the folder. We have a main function in one of the modules in that folder. So a package is just a collection of files inside of a directory. So that means other.odin here, right, will be part of the same package and it will have other function. So here, for example, we can say, hey, let's take an int, let's return an int like this. We can do it. Printf here, hello. And now we can actually call other function here, right? With some argument. So 42, for example, here, right? The reason we can actually call other function without any qualification is because in a package, we can use all of the functions. They are in a package is essentially a shared namespace inside of there, right? So all of the files in one package can just use each other, right? If we use this package from somewhere else, we would generally speaking just say sandbox dot something, right? But a package is effectively the unit of compilation, and that unit of compilation shares everything, right? So here we will say Odin build sandbox. We can actually just do run if we want to just run like this. And now we have hello 43. So this is a neat thing. We just have folders, right? There's nothing more to it, really. There's no specification that needs to be made at all. And of course, Odin is not unique in this respect, right? But it is nice that that's the level we have, right? This effectively actually means that, well, dependency management and so on is not necessarily a thing. And that sounds odd, right? Because of course, dependency management is such a bother mostly everywhere. But I found that in Odin, well, any way you can get that folder, it really doesn't matter, right? Writing some library and using it in Odin is, well, I mean, it's trivial. There's really not that much to it. I have projects that use Git subtrees. Of course, I don't use Git submodules because that's very annoying, but Git subtrees. When you clone that project, you don't even need to care that this comes from elsewhere. All you needed to do was Git clone and then my project, and then you compile it. You wouldn't even know that this is based on Git subtrees, right? And that's very free. There's no actual package manager that needs to come into this at all. And that's very neat, right? When there is a package manager for this language, it will be mostly trivial to actually write. And the fact is, it kind of doesn't need one either. But yeah, so we have this function, right? We can see here that we have parameter here, a parameter. If we wanted multiple int parameters, we could set x comma y like this. If we want something else, like a float here, we could say f32. And of course, the return parameter comes after here. And in this function, we have access to, well, basically everything that you kind of expect, right? So for loops, while loops. If we wanted to say, for example, like this, we could do this. And this is valid code. And of course, you can see here, we're being explicit. This is less than. If we wanted 10 to actually be included, we would do equals. And this is such a small thing, but honestly, don't you kind of love this though? It is so clear what's going to happen. There is no ambiguity at all. If you switch from another language, you can never be confused about what's going to be included in this range. And again, Odin is not unique here, right? But it's just so nice to have, right? So we have this, this is a ranged for loop, of course. This exists in many languages. Nothing super unique either there. Odin does the same thing as Go, where it uses the for keyword for, well, everything. So for example, if I is, or X is less than 10, we could do this, for example. Here we can't actually modify X. We would actually have to say X is X here, because this is passed by value and so on. But yeah, we can use the while loop here. We can have an infinite loop, which has no arguments there. We can use a old style, actually let's do this. Like this. Of course, we cannot do plus plus. That's my C++ brain. So here we can do this. And this is not necessarily something you'll be doing all the time, because we saw we have other tools to actually deal with a lot of the iteration and so on. We have ifs. These are not anything super interesting either, right? We can use if and else if. We have switches. So switch x, case 0, return 0, and so on and so on. This is actually supposed to be case here, like this. And we're gonna remove our second parameter here. And so switch here is completely doable here. We can also use several values here, right? So if we have 0 or 1, we have this. We can replace if else and so on by saying switch like this, case x . So here you can see we have predicates instead, and this is basically like you replace if else clauses, right? So it's a lot like cond in that sense instead. So these are the kind of basic building blocks in terms of just procedural code, right? But then what do we actually use with this, right? So let's take a look at how we talk about data types and so on.